Hey, Sammy friends, welcome to the Joyous Sam with Rachel. I'm Rachel Kuhn, and it's our wonderful Wednesday. Today, I'm sharing with you my last two Christmas card swaps for the year. Half of these are about stamp sets that will be retiring soon, and half of them are carrying over. Watch and pick out which ones are your favorites and add to your must get list before Christmas comes this year. Go ahead and hold my flip, and we'll get started. Hope you guys can see everything okay. It's not too shiny and not too dull for our video today. I do see, oh man, a little spot here in the right corner. So I apologize for that being on our view today. And I won't even mess with it to fix it. So I apologize. But it is a wonderful Wednesday. That means when you order from my online store today or any Wednesday for the month of December using this hostess code, I will send you our wonderful Wednesday gift, which for this month is the retiring gold holly leaves. These are beautiful. Let me grab some out so you can kind of see, shake it around. These leaves that are more like a fabric versus paper, and they are great for adding embellishing to all of your favorite things. And these, like I said, are retiring soon. They will be gone, if not sooner, but by January 4th. And they are on a super deal. I think they're a little over $2, originally, I think six. So gold holly leaves will be yours when you order online on a Wednesday. All right, so I have two sets of swaps to share with you today. One is from a group called Demo Swap. Those are ladies who are part of the Queen Stamp Age group, but they gather together every other month and they have different themes and they are based out of Utah. These ladies have been swapping for almost 8 years now and are just amazing, amazing stampers. So I will share with you those cards first, and then I will share with you the other cards from the Royal Heart Stampers, and hopefully I have them all here. All right, yes, okay, perfect. So the first card I want to share with you is made by Cheryl Holden, and she made the card using the Santa's Delivery. So she has this cute little snowman here where she's Santa Claus in a train. Definitely not a snowman. Oh my goodness. And I love how she's used the dies, cut these out. The dies are on a special deal. So instead of using the bundle for this one, be sure to separate it, grab the stamp set alone, and then buy the dies separately because you will save more during this last chance sale. It's super cute. It has this little ribbon here, which I think we're going to go ahead and open it up and so we can see what the inside is. And the inside continues on. It says Santa Claus is coming to town. She has some beautiful use of designer series paper. She's done the stamping here. I'm loving the train track. Love that. And her colorful images here. So that's a super fun card there. I usually don't have cards opening from the right this way. So that is definitely a little bit more fun. And I always tie the bow to close it back up. Great card, Cheryl. The next one is another fun fold and is made by Cindy Hafner. That was Cheryl Holden. This one is using a stamp set that is also retiring. It is called Christmas Banners. And she has done a beautiful job. Let me show you a little bit here. So when we open it up, it has this cool another diamond shape here that's been covered up. And if you look at it, it's almost like a house shape here. You can kind of see how she made it. She cut off these two corners so that it does this cool little flip there for the front to be, because that's the actual inside of that card base there that flips for us to see. And it has the awesome extra piece here on the inside. I love that the DSP shows up on the back side of this one, which is the backside Christmas tree, or that granny apple green, more solid look there. Super, super fun card, Cindy. The next one is made by Margine Nation, and she uses the soon-to-be-retiring Jingle 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 stamp set. I just love the way this one turned out, that cute little hat. She's used a little red rhinestone, and the jingle has been colored in by a stamped image, which is the coolest thing to do. Instead of having to color it yourself, that was just stamped in there, and it is way, way cute. I do love the dies that she's used here, too, to create a awesome background, and she's used the oh my goodness, Reckled rectangles, I think they're called. They're one of my favorites, and I always mess up on the names, so I apologize there. Over on my blog, you will have the names of all the stampers underneath their card and a link to the item they use most. So the link for this one has the jingle, all the jingle, jingle, jingle stamp set. The next two are use the same set, so I'm going to show them at the same time. This used the Spruce Up stamp set. This one was made by Susan Lomain, and this one's made by Natalie Wohl, both showing different techniques of how to use this. They have the Spruce Up outline dies, which I believe are already sold out. So that's the sad thing about this card, is that the dies are no longer available, but the stamp set is. It is retiring, and she did a great job creating this cool-looking holy background and using her DSP. And she's even stamped a little bit of the candy canes in the inside there. Super, super cute. Natalie, she did more of a window card, is what I like to call it, because it looks like we're looking through the window when we open it up, and the tree's in the inside right there. I love that brick embossing folder she's used to add some texture to the front and create a fun, almost like a fireplace ode to right there using that brick, which I just love. So those are two great cards, one made by Susan and one by Natalie. Let me go ahead and put those aside real quick, and that's all for the demo swap. The next ones are from the Royal Heart Stampers. That's my team. Natalie will also organize this swap for me, sent them all out, collected it, sent it out, and did a perfect job with that. These are stampers who are part of my team. The other one here were the queens, and they're kind of like your side sisters is what I like to call those ladies there. All related, but just in different ways. All right, so this first card is made by Christina Kunzler. I always say her name wrong, so let me show it to you. That's her name. Again, that'll be over on my Facebook. Well, over on my blog as well for you to reference. She made this beautiful fun fold using mostly the designer series paper, which is part of the Last Chance sale. It's usually like $12, now down to $7. It is called the Santa's Express DSP. This is a fun fold, so when we open it up, it has all these fun trees that are popping up in there, these great labels that she's stamped on. She is all about the fun folds, and she loves things that pop. So she's great about finding ways to make it, and this is DSP. This isn't cardstock at all, so you look on the back side, it has that pattern on that side and the front side, and there's not a stitch of cardstock except for this little label she's die cut there. This is all DSP here as well. She did a fantastic job. These wonderful snowflakes were also on the Last Chance deal. They could be currently gone because they were such a good deal. I think they were down to like $2 after being like six, and you get like 24 of these beautiful snowflakes. All right, the next one is made by Natalie Wohl, and she used a stamp set that's actually carrying over. She used the Christmas to Remember for her sayings here, but the embossing folder she used, which she's inked up and then she's ran through her die cutting machine to create that two-tone look there with the emboss, is called the Whimsical Woodland 3D Embossing Folder, and it is on the Last Chance list. It's also discounted, so usually like $8 is now down to $4, and it is a great deal. If you love embossing folders, you should totally add this one to your list, because it is fantastic. Love that card, Natalie. My card, I'm gonna throw in here so you can see it too. I actually have two of them, so they're exactly the same. But it has our cute little gnome. This guy is, his dies are carrying over, the paper is not, and the stamp set is not. So the stamp set that has this greeting will not be here. So make sure you add that to your list. Mine does open up to have a gift card inside. A little pocket there, and with that one, let's see, there we go. If you don't want to use a gift card as a pocket or have a gift card there, you could just leave it empty and they would not know the wiser. Just a pretty banner on the bottom of that paper. So I love that one. And then I have two more left. This next one is beautiful. It's made by Heidi Engstrom. She's a member of my team, and she's using a stamp set that is also carrying over. It's called the Regal Reindeer, and I'm just in love with Her coloring for this one is just amazing. And what a cute little scene this is. A little child. Looks like they're trying to feed the reindeer that cute little apple there. I love her softness of colors that she chose. So it's more of a brighter color. Look here. She also has this cool trees, which I'm thinking she must have. Oh, I didn't even know the technique she used for this. I'm going to have to ask her. And it looks like it's been watercolored, and it has these fun little speckles of water as well to kind of resist the ink that she has underneath it, or almost like delete it. But it looks like falling snow. Just a beautiful and all around great card. Love, love this one. The last one is made by my team member, Mindy McNabb from Ohio. She made this beautiful, very traditional, crisp-looking card using the Merriest Moments. And this one is also carrying over. So if you are loving this one, don't worry. Add it to your collection now, and you can continue playing with it and have lots of ideas and inspiration. I love the dye that she used to create this banner, and I love that it's white on white. It looks so crisp and clean. And then the bright colors right here is all you need to finish off this card. So beautifully done. And the inside, we do have another little saying, thinking of you this festive season. So I'm excited to send this card out to one of my stamping friends, and that way I can enjoy it as well. Let me get all these cards back in so you can see them. I would love to know what your thoughts are, which ones are your favorites, things that you're like, oh, that has to go on my list now that I've seen how, or different ideas. That's what I love about swaps. Where I was like, oh, this one wasn't even on my list. And now that I've seen a card in person, I'm just in awe and loving it. And I love seeing the different fun folds. I hope you guys have too. Be sure to order between now and midnight on Wednesday, and I'll send you those gold holly leaves for your wonderful Wednesday gift. Happy stamping, everyone. Goodbye.